In this video, you're going to learn how to use a nasal saline rinse kit. We'll also cover what a nasal irrigation set is and what you can use it for, reasons you can as well as shouldn't do it, a practical step-by-step demonstration where I demonstrate this on myself, plus where you can purchase the kit, how long it takes to work, and finally, we'll cover possible side effects of conducting nasal irrigation. Please do remember this is an educational video only, and for individual clinical advice, always speak to your own health provider first, especially if you're uncertain if this procedure is suitable for you. So let's just briefly explore what a nasal irrigation set is and why you would use it. Well, a nasal irrigation set, commonly referred to as a nasal wash or sinus rinse kit, is a device designed to rinse the nasal cavity with a saline solution. It typically consists of a bottle, like a Neil Med Sinus Rinse Kit, or a pot, often resembling a small teapot, like a Neti pot, along with packets of a saline mixture. Now, the main purpose of nasal irrigation is to clear out excess mucus, allergens, irritants, and bacteria from the nasal passages and sinuses, and it's commonly used by people who've got sinus infections, allergies, colds, or who are around a lot of dust or pollution. So now we know what it is and what it can be used for, well, who can as well as shouldn't use this? So a nasal rinse kit can be useful if you've got nasal congestion due to colds, flu, allergies, or sinusitis. You suffer from post-nasal drip, which is where mucus from your nose drips down into your throat and causes you to clear your throat a lot or cough, as well as sinus-related headaches, as well as exposure to dust, pollen, or other allergens. Now, in addition to the people who can use it, certain people shouldn't use it, and this is the case especially if you have a completely blocked nasal passage on both sides, you have a current ear infection or a history of lots of ear infections in the past, recent surgery on your nose unless it was recommended by your healthcare provider, the presence of certain nasal conditions like a deviated septum, and finally people with weakened immune systems or certain medical conditions. Now, there are exceptions to this, but you should always speak to your own health provider first if these apply to you and you feel like this procedure is something that you might benefit from. Again, if you're uncertain about any of these things or you want to check with your own health provider, it's always safest to do this. So now let's take a look at a practical demonstration of how to do this. First, take the kit out of the box and read the information leaflet. You should have the saline rinse solution packets, an instruction leaflet, and the rinse bottle as well as spout in the box. Read the instructions fully before starting the procedure. Next, add the saline solution to a clean, dry bottle. Then add clean, sterile water to the bottle. Tie on the bottle top and shake it a few times to make sure that the rinse solution is fully dissolved. Once you're ready to start the wash, stand over the sink. Turn your head at a 45 degree angle and look down ever so slightly and put the spout into the higher of the two nostrils. Once you're ready to begin the wash, press the valve at the top of the bottle. Water will then begin flowing through the lower of the two nostrils. Now it's important that you continue to breathe through the mouth during this whole process. The solution will drain out of the nostril closest to the sink basin or the lower of the two nostrils. Continue to run the solution into your nostril until the bottle is empty. Now, once you've used all of the solution, remove the dispensing bottle from your nostril and bring your head up. Breathe through both nostrils to clear out your nose and use a tissue to absorb any remaining saline and mucus that drips from your nose. Once you've done this on one side, you can repeat this on the other side. You should aim to do this once or twice a day. Now, in order to clean your saline rinse bottle, wash it in warm soapy water and let it air dry, and never share the bottle with someone else. I've included a link in the description box of this video for where you can purchase this particular kit that I've used in the video. But there are lots available on the market, so please do just choose the one that works best for you. In terms of how long it takes to work, well, the effects of nasal irrigation can vary depending on the individual and the severity of their symptoms. Some people may experience immediate relief from congestion and improved nasal breathing shortly after use. However, for some people, particularly those with chronic conditions, it might take several days of consistent use to notice significant improvements. Now, it's really important to follow the recommended usage instructions for the best possible results. Finally, what are possible side effects? Well, whilst nasal irrigation is generally safe, there are potential side effects, especially if this is not performed correctly. These can include, but are not limited to, nasal irritation or discomfort, nosebleeds, especially if the nasal passages are very dry or irritated, ear discomfort or an ear infection, particularly if the solution is not drained properly. And in rare cases, using unsterile or contaminated water can lead to serious infections. And for this reason, it's important not to use tap water and instead to use bottled water or sterile water. Finally, overuse can lead to nasal lining dryness and irritation. For more information, please do check out the resources that I've included in the description box of this video. I do hope you found the video useful and informative. If you've got any questions, please do leave them in the comments section. And remember that you can find the link for where to purchase the kit in the description box of the video as well. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe for weekly medical education videos. Until next time, bye.